Hello everyone, SMA Watts here. We're about to play some Legacy Tribal. And yeah, it happens. Alright, so we have turn 2, Lotlith Troll, not much else. I'm gonna keep it because it doesn't seem like a terrible hand, it just is missing, I don't know, some zazz. Not a very zazzy hand. Alright, so Swamp into Woodlot Cemetery, I believe, will be the plan. Okay, now the sound's working fine. Yep. Fetch. When he's on red green, and I know he's running generator servant because I saw like a bit of him playing again that was kind of where he was kind of mana screwed, so I don't really know what his plan is though. But generator servant actually kind of tells me sort of what the plan is. It's to play something really big. All right, well. All creatures. I'll just trade it for the gem. I'm pretty sure I'm the control deck in this game. Because I'm pretty sure he's going for ramp, which means I want to take advantage of the fact that more often than not, I will be ahead cards. Obviously, Lotlith Troll is not exactly the card advantage engine. But it is hard for a red deck not running Incinerate to actually get rid of. Nylea, Goddess of the Hunt. Well, indestructible, so I'm guessing there's a devotion plan in there. Would really have kind of liked a, I don't know. A zombie. Grave Scrabble would have been great. I mean, he's only really in here because he synergizes so well with Lotlith Troll and Stockpile. Take the other one from. One from fetching. Oh, he fetched twice. This is something relatively large. Well, we can't Maelstrom Pulse the forest. Can you get in there and take out Nissa? It's card disadvantage, but I'd rather keep a Maelstrom Pulse in my hand for, like, another Nissa. That 0-5 Trampling Defender is hilarious. Get in there, Love Troll. If he blocks, I pitch the Gray Merchant. Keep him off Devotion. Keep my troll getting larger, more unstoppable. Well, we'll eventually be able to Chainer's Edict flashback, though. Okay, well, that's not, I'm not worried about. Doesn't add to Devotion, and doesn't even really chump block me. Bice him a turn. Unless I draw a Grave Scrabbler. Can they make it big enough? Oh, he's just absorbing some damage. It is the right technical play. I didn't even think about that, but yeah. It doesn't alter the clock, but it means if he has something else that he can throw in front of it, it does. That's something big. Avenger of Zendikar? Deals 6 damage to each creature with flying. Okay. I'm guessing he's on elementals? How much mana do I have? A ton. Oh, Lotlith Troll. You're my boy, Troll. It was one of those. We both got flooded, but he just couldn't answer. Like I had one more threat. I had a threat, really, and I had enough answers. I assume Kuma is taking care of tournament business right now, so might be a moment. That is an interesting factor. So apparently with version 4, my frame rate's actually pretty like is lower. It's only like 20 frames per second. But I don't really think that matters all that much since how much are you really paying attention to Magic's frame rate? Okay, this hand's also unexciting. I'll keep it, I mean, it's really just Life Bane, hope for the best. So I'm guessing we're going with turn 2 Generator Servant. Enables him to play a turn 3 Nylea. Didn't see anything else that costs 4. Also enables him to play a turn 2 Nissa. That's not a Generator Servant though, so. I will not have a lot of options for it, so I think it's best just to abrupt. Like, I think the only things in his deck I can abrupt decay are the Wall of Roots and the Generator Servant. And Omni. Let's see what we can get. Everything cool? Just the Nissa. Nissa's powerful. Like, I'm probably gonna have to save my Maelstrom Balls for Nissa. So I think, yeah, okay. 5/5. Ooh, Nissa actually combos pretty well with Omnath. Doing it pre-combat just so I can F6 once I attack. Maybe I should have pulsed. Ooh, Avengevine. Well, can't quite race Avengevine. I know he's got, let's see, played. Forest, so I believe he, yeah, and then he played the tag. So I don't know what's, I know he's got one of his cards is Nissa. False that. Can I just outrace Nissa? Seems sketchy. He must have done something he wants to give haste to. Oh, he drew enough creatures that he could. Wow. Well, I was going with the odds of him being able to actually get the Vengevine into play for free there, I was pretty sure were pretty low. So we're going to go down to 7. And that won't take Nissa. So I need 2 blockers, so I think I have to draw Mutilate now, though. No, it doesn't help. I don't have enough swamp. Okay. If I block Omnath and Vengevine, I can kill the Vengevine. Omnath gets, and I go to 5. He then burns the mana from Omnath. Actually, he can't burn the mana from Omnath then. And because it'll kill Omnath, and he gets to play Nissa. I think that's the correct play. If he didn't realize that was going to happen. Oh, I guess he did. He's casting another Vengevine. So makes a 4/4 trampler. Any way I can survive a Nissa activation here? I mean, I can get another turn. No, I'm pretty sure I'm dead. Like, I don't think there's any way I could have drawn. I'd play first. Yes, I'd like to play first. This is a pretty piss poor hand. I'm gonna keep it. All your lands are swamps. So I think we cycle the blessings. Obviously, desperately trying to hit our land drop here. A symbol on that. Doesn't look a weatherlight symbol. Oh, it is the weatherlight symbol, just doesn't look right. Okay. Hey, we hit it. Omnath. Okay. Get in there, boy. my only creature I've drawn. Fortunately, Taken Block. You have Mutilate. It'll be good against Nissa. All my lands are swamped. You got a removal spell. I haven't seen like all right, now an interesting thing happens if he actually was to like try and regenerate him. If his mana ever pool ever drops below 2 green this turn, Omnath just dies. As soon as the state-based effect is checked. Okay, so he's going to kill my Lotlith Troll. Still got a 2-for-1 out of it. Alright, well, green, black, off troll. Because you have to keep, like, the way Omnath works is so bizarre. Like, he's so counterintuitive to the way every other creature ever has worked. Black, green, stockpile. Clearly doing something. Playing Nissa. And hopefully untapping his forest so that I can Abrupt Decay Omnath. Not technically wrong, it's just opens up a window for me. Whenever a player casts a spell, you may put a plus one counter on Forgotten Edge and end of your upkeep. Okay, so that's wasn't doing what I thought he was doing. Okay. I guess we'll destroy Omnath here now. I suppose I should have destroyed it in response. Somewhat loose. That's sort of like the worst card for me to have drawn. Alright, well. Oh, let's pulse that. Yeah, you get another count. Bottle of Trolls here to save the day. Or not good. That is the height of not good. Like, Blessing, my Abrupt Decay. Yeah, I know. That's like kind of the worst card I could have drawn. Like, I'd like to draw a creature at some point. I've drawn three Gaia's Blessings, and a deck that only has two. I kind of have to just take 10 here. Crazy. Yeah. Well, it doesn't really matter. I need to rip a land this turn. Sadly, it doesn't help as much as it should. Oh, wait. Yeah, I know. But it puts me in a position to almost not die. All right, well, we're kind of in quite the pickle now. Maybe it would have been technically correct to discard the Grey Merchant. I mean, it's sort of the same thing. Well, it is just basically the same thing. I need to draw a removal spell off the top of my library. It needs to be a Putrefy. Like if I don't pull a Putrefy, is there a 2-mana option here? No. Don't think there is. Well, Putrefy was in my top like 10 cards.